Good morning students, welcome back to today class. The last class we saw about the last class we saw about different types of soils and importance of soils and soil formations. And there are different types of soils found in India, like alluvial soil, black soil, and lateral soil, mountain soil. So these are the different types of soil found in our Indian country. And today topic is our water resources. So water resources, this is our third lesson. And the water, so in this lesson we are going to see about the sources of water and the irrigation and the water pollution and wastage. So these are the topic we are going to see about this from this lesson. And the first one, water. So why we are depending the water, first of all? And what is the use of water? So water is a very important one in our daily life. So in our day starts with water. Day starts with water. So first of all, we are wake up from the bed, isn't it? So what work we are doing first? So toileting work and brushing, bathing. So all the cleaning activities, we are depending the water. So water is a very important one. So without water, we can't live, isn't it? So water is one of a important, and it is a called a natural resources because it is easily available from nature. So it is called a natural resources. The water is present surface of the earth. In our earth, it's covered 3/4. For example, 3 portions are fully covered with water. So most of the portions are fully covered with water, and the sea and ocean water, it's called salty water. So salty or saline water. Okay, there are different types of water sources available. Different types of water sources are available on our earth, and in our earth 100% water is covered. 97% of water is called salt water because that portion is fully covered with oceans and sea areas. So that is called sea water. Remaining 3% only fresh water. So where we can get this fresh water? So first of all, the rain water, it's a main source of fresh water. Rainwater, it's called one of a main source of fresh water, and mainly we are most of the water receiving from the rain. Mainly most of the water receiving from the rain. So rainwater, it's called one of a fresh water in India. Okay, there are a lot of water bodies present in our country. The water bodies can be divided into two types. So the water bodies divided into two types. One is the surface water. The one water, so water bodies is divided into two types. One it's called surface water, and the another one it's called ground water. So first one it's called surface water, and the another one it's called ground water. Surface water means the rivers originate and starts from the mountain places, because most of the mountain present in the northern side, the mountains are covered with snow. So due to the heavy temperature, the mountains the snows started to melt. So if it is melt, means what we will get? So water. So the ice cube, it's automatically melt, means it is form a liquid. Liquid means that is a form a water stage. So this is called surface water. So river, pond, lake and streams form source of surface water, because most of the rivers that originate, starting place, started in the mountains, get water from the melting snow and rain. But the peninsular areas depend on the rain only. So, in the peninsula's areas, rivers fully depends on the rains. So, these are called surface water. Surface water means, so that the rivers are starting from the northern plains and through the mountain that place is receiving the water. Next one, it's called groundwater. So groundwater means is the water that seeps into the earth's surface. So under the earth, so groundwater is a water that seeps into the earth's surface. Lenna mena pandrom appina vandu we are collecting this water. So these are called two types of water. One is the surface water and another one is called groundwater. So dear students, so learn this topic today's topic. Thank you.